Hello!
Hello!
Hey, everybody. Now I don't know where I put my phone. Oh, there it is. So I'm losing things. I'm losing everything today, folks.
I love the way our intro is always the exact same. Right, yes. Everyone has their own unique hellos. I'm Ike. John says some random bullshit. We're like, for fuck's sake. And then we actually get going.
Hey, up, Doc.
Well, I haven't said anything yet.
Oh, fuck. Now you have. Shut up.
That's enough.
Yeah, it's enough for us to tell you to shut up, Sam, so...
So, I hate to say I just stole the initiative. I totally just stole the initiative.
Yes. Recap.
So, hello there to our new player.
New player? New character, John?
I'm sorry, but you have to get really into character so much that it becomes you, Tom. So,
oh, shit. Alright, my bad.
You're already dead.
Yeah.
So, how are you playing Dom?
Do you want to do that again? This time your character token select as you actually go into the initiative tracker.
Sure. Can I keep my old initiative though?
Yes.
Yeah.
Basically, Sam, I'm not saying Dom's totally a reference, but he's totally a reference.
Well, shit. Now I'm going to spend all my fucking time guessing.
I put in stupid shit that could happen. On,
you should have waited to see if you found it.
Ah, true.
Okay, so last time, does someone want to give us a recap on what happened last time?
I hope Rick
very slowly with some sad music playing in the background onto Ruka's corpse at this point.
Unfortunately, sad music would infringe copyright.
We killed the pixie thing though.
Shit.
Just imagine the sad walkway music from the old Hulk movie.
Hold on a sec. I have an anti-copyright way of doing this.
Is there one on the jukebox?
Is it a dub? You can't do a jukebox. It's been disabled.
Yeah,
there is some music there.
Oh yeah, sure.
I'm sorry.
Oh wait, is Rick getting his accord you now?
Yeah.
I thought so.
No, this is meant to be quick. This is quickly turning into a very long segment.
Someone start talking!
For a second, I thought you were playing What If God Was One of Us.
Just imagine Foo Fighters.
Rick,
my hero.
Live, because it's telling me I'm
the best!
My hero!
So last time, we lost someone very close to us.
Oh, are we live?
No.
We're not live, we're just recording the VOD because Rick's internet can't handle the stream.
Ah, that makes sense. I understand now.
Yeah, so if anyone's wondering why this wasn't live, that's why.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I understand as well.
Now I feel disheartened. Fuck.
I'm down with the...
Sickness?
Yes, the one.
You're down with the sickness.
Okay, yeah, anyway, yeah. As I was saying, last time we lost someone very close to us. Ruka fell in glorious combat.
She does what she loved doing the most.
Trying to kill
bleeding and screaming.
Trying to hunt down her friends and chop them in half with her big axe. It is an axe, isn't it?
Yeah, it was a two-handed axe.
Yeah.
Which is easily like the size of every other party map.
Yeah, we're gonna have trouble looting your corpse.
Yeah, it's probably the head of the axe was probably like, you know, the size of me.
Well, I probably can't enchant it for lightness because I don't know how to do that.
Meanwhile, back up above town, the human fighter Dom had just arrived in town, narrowly missing the festival.
Sucks to be him. It was a good festival.
That's me.
Why would you like to tell people?
So, I was just trotting through town, you know, as you do.
First of all, I would like to ask, did you come in through the north of Pathfinder?
Probably south.
Okay, so you saw the little piece of reflective material? And a note to see yourself as others see you.
I probably just ignored it because I just don't care. And then just kept on strutting. probably went along trying to find some wenches and booze. Then I ended up... What was it, a sinkhole, or was it just a hole just appeared?
It was more as you went over it. Your weight broke through, and the ground gave way. And you fell through.
Right.
Sorry, I had to stop there because I wanted to say a burning ring of fire, and then I realised, no, you didn't.
I fell into hell. Fucking doom. Let's go. Yeah. Oh.
No, you fell through.
Mm.
And as you can see from the dice log, Dom did not land well.
No. Huh. It could have been worse, but it could have been better.
Could have been worse, yeah.
He landed badly, but aware of his surroundings.
No,
very aware of his surroundings. Very yes. aware.
Oh, John, I'll say for reference, that should have been a 16. Because I didn't realise I could have put points in my acrobatics, so I put two more in.
Fair enough.
So that would have actually been a 16. Should have mentioned that beforehand, but fuck it.
Yes, but never mind.
So I landed chance.
You fell down. But it wasn't a bad fall, as Tom can see from his surroundings.
Mm.
However, he did take 8 points of non-lethal damage.
Pow.
So would I put that... So would I deduct that from my actual sense of stomach?
No, you would put that into one of the other bars. Because once that becomes greater than your actual HP, as in current HP, not max HP, you will fall unconscious.
Okay, is there anything for non-lethal? There we go. 8. Yeah. I found it.
Ah, okay.
Cool.
I will just adjust your character model to have bar 2 for non-lethal, if I can find that.
Falling damage is non-lethal, you say?
No. Just in this instance.
I mean, I'd only be starting off the game basically dead. Although I'd like to gen again.
You'll see why I've ruled it to be that if you go back to where you started.
Oh, back to where I started, as in before I fell, or after?
No, as in where you are now. You'll probably have to do this why it's not legal.
Was it because I was on the stairs and I did a sick roll?
It's because you fell down a lot of stairs, yes.
Okay, cool. Do you mean majestically rolled, like
no.
Limp Bizkit?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Sorry, I can just imagine you, John. Not to make judgments on John's character here, but I can just imagine you pushing Will downstairs and shouting as he tumbles arse overhead, "Don't worry, Will. Falling downstairs is non-lethal damage."
for those of you that are unaware, Will is one of my housemates.
Who played D&D with as well?
Yes.
Okay, so John.
It is your turn first.
Is this door locked or open?
It is open.
All right, I'll kind of get out my bow and kind of push up against slowly and bow with my armor whilst I'm moving it to open the door. If that makes sense.
That does indeed make sense.
Thanks.
I need to zoom in because I can't select the door from that far.
Ooh. Okay.
So, for the benefit of everyone else, I will describe what Tom sees. You see a staircase.
Okay. I'll do the same with this door, John. Oh, boy.
And that is your move action.
Okay.
No, I should probably actually like put that on stats.
So what is that like a is that like an imp or something?
That is a Vargwheel.
Assuming it's not particularly fancy then, is it?
No.
Does it count as a
I'm actually opening the bestiary up now.
Okay. Cause you're gonna get that on.
Because I was like, oh, stats will be in the adventure book. No.
Okay. And also, yeah, is it a magical beast or an apparition? What's your at it?
The Vogwheel is a outsider.
Ah, so don't get the bonus.
No.
That's fine.
We're all outsiders.
Okay, so what I will do
Maybe it's cold outside.
So I'll attack it twice. I get an extra point on my damage, but I get an... Oh, I can just add it into the... Oh, no, I can't. Okay. So it's a minus one to hit, but a plus one on the damage. So... So 18. Nice. So I do 8 and 6 damage to it.
So would you like to tell people how you're doing two attacks here?
So, yeah. Because I'm fairly good with a bow, I got this special ability called Rapid Shot.
And does that allow you to do it as a standard action?
I think it does. I'll check now.
You should check, because if it's a full round action, you can't do it.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't really matter, because, I mean, it, you know, the first one would count otherwise if you can't do it. And that's still a hit. They're both hits.
My PDF loader is so slow. It is a full attack action.
Then you can only make one attack.
Alright, I'll just stick to my first shot then.
First shot does 7 damage, slams into it good.
8.
Oh, 8, okay.
Yes, because it's been 30 feet. Cool.
So yeah, that is a good chunk of damage dealt to the Vargwheel.
So as I open the door with my bow, and as I draw it back, I see the imp and just instantly just twang and just shoot it.
It is a flying head.
And what if I shot it in the eye?
Then it would probably become like very close friends with Grunya. But now, panning over to the other side, we have Whimsy.
Pow, pow, pow! Is essentially what I'm going to do, because all I really have that doesn't put me in more danger is to use telekinetic fist and punch the first Sinspawn in the face with my mind. So, yeah. Let's move all of these. I've not actually got it set up as a rolled attack thing, so I'm just going to do flat.
I've now got Spawn of Wrath on the brain to the tune of School of Rock.
Brilliant. Okay, so it's a ranged touch attack.
Which is just a standard dex roll. BAB plus dex.
Does that hit it?
That, I can tell you, Nina, hits it.
Way! And I do... 1d4 damage.
I just put everything in double square brackets, and I don't have to deal with that. So.
Yeah, true. And then I'm going to run backwards.
So you get, what, 24 movement?
What's my... It's been so long since I've... Been...
I'd advise getting round the corner over getting a long way. 20.
Yeah. Aren't we going to try and block ourselves up at the...
Well,
there?
We could block here. I think Grunya has a better chance of getting there than we have of getting there without the Sinspawn catching us. We have tiny, tiny legs.
True.
I mean, his aren't big.
But they're not fair, tiny.
Yeah, I can reach there.
Yeah, I think the Sinspawn can move faster than us.
Well, what's my speed?
I'm going to move there. I think you're 20 as well, aren't you?
Slow and purposeful, 20.
Oh, great. You've taken a trait which literally has the word slow in it.
No, he's just making a reference to
racial.
Oh, is that an actual thing?
I think it's... one second.
Oh, great.
Slow and steady. Dwarves have a base speed of 20 feet, but their speed is never modified by armor or encumbrance.
Yeah, that's one of their base traits.
My speed's 20.
I took it by becoming a dwarf.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was Whimsy's turn. And now it's him spawn.
Yeah.
Oh, I can actually get there.
We loved you, Dalkinic.
Okay. So, the one in the front is going to make a melee attack against you, but not just any melee attack.
It's going to fuck you up.
It's going for a grab.
I hope you.
Shall I start playing the funeral music now?
I don't know, because.
No, Tom, I'll never fucking die.
Although I get to roll this now, it does provoke an attack of opportunity from you.
Oh, yay. I get to hit it.
For fuck's sake.
Oh! Oh! It failed!
All of five, yes.
And I get the attack of opportunity. Yes.
Yes.
Inventory. Let me get out my hammer. What? What?
Oh.
What?
Is it hammer time?
I may be out of practice.
You just swing.
Take two. Yeah, okay. When you put the fumble.
So, so we confirming fumble?
Yeah, roll to confirm fumble.
How do you roll to confirm? Is it if you roll badly?
Oh, you don't confirm the fumble.
For some reason, there I clicked melee attack instead of hammer.
Does it matter?
I have fun times involving dice. Why don't I just get hobbies that don't hate me? Anyhow, I'll get the funeral music ready.
Nice.
Yes.
Because this is about to stop going well for me.
Nina, do Ransuers have reach?
Ransuers, I believe they do.
Well, so you all got one earlier. I just wonder if you noticed that.
Yes. The Ransuer has disarm and reach.
Reach, okay. Well, the one behind it is going to use a Ransuer to attack you.
Yay.
Well, not fumble, so Grunyar's turn. Yeah, it swings over the top of its fellows. He tried to grab you to stop you from getting away. It just goes way over your head. If he forgets that you're a bit small, probably would have decapitated you if you were a human or a half orc, but.
Oh, so it would have just cut a bit of my hair off if he had done it to me.
Yeah.
Or poked you in the other eye.
Yeah.
No! That face when you become the blind tank, so you have to be led everywhere.
I think that face when would be a picture of a cyclops.
Okay,
but just think, you are the king in the land of the blind.
So, if you don't go across any of the platforms, Sam, you can get to that square though.
Okay, that's... What is that? That's 5, 10, 15.
Every second diagonal is 10, so that's 20.
But can I run, or... Would you say the changing direction is...
I see, yeah, that's a very good point. I would say you have to make an acrobatics test to do that.
Okay, so if I don't run, I can just move, but if I do
if
run...
If you don't run, your first movement can get you there. If you were to run, then yeah, you.
I could. If I were to run, what would my movement range be?
Ooh, what is the effects of run? Let's look that up. Because I do not remember what that is for Pathfinder.
Is it double or triple?
I believe for you it is triple.
So I'd be able to go 60. Ooh, guys, this might be worth it. But consider the holes that I'm about to fall into are deep. Because you gave a description when I headbutted that guy into the hole.
Right.
How deep are the holes, roughly?
They are about 20 feet, I believe I gave you. I'm going to check that now, but I believe that was what I said.
Basically, guys, do you think I should risk it on the off chance that I'd be trapped in a hole with a zombie that I'd have to kill and have no way of getting out until one of you helps me?
Well, I'm going to say, Sam, is you can't ask them on this, because they're too far away.
Oh, shit. That's a good point. This is why we need a scion with telepathy. No one's climbing out of that without a ladder.
Especially not a dwarf.
But remember, they do have covers on them. So you can.
Yeah, but they're all flimsy and stuff.
Remember, it is a reflex save if you step on them to not fall through, so it isn't just automatic.
Oh, a reflex save. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, but my reflex is shit.
And including your armor as well.
And I'm wearing heavy armor. And, well,
time to make the choice. Countdown music.
Do you guys think that you'd be able to hold out for another turn? Oh yeah, I can't. Yeah, I'm gonna move. Normal. Just
okay.
There.
And then that is your movement action. So what about your standard action? You can do another movement.
Oh shit, I can. Yeah. I do another movement. One, two, three.
Four. Okay. That is Grunyar's turn. Now, going back to good old Dom.
So, John, would my last round would have counted as a surprise?
You would technically be going against its flat-footed AC.
Okay.
What being a surprise round, you would have just got flat-footed bonus.
Oh, so surprise is slightly different.
Basically, if you start off combat, you would get a surprise round, but since we're doing this simultaneously... I'll roll this as side by side, so yeah, I'll give you a surprise round.
Okay, cool. So does that mean I get another action, or does that mean...
No, it just means you will get your... that he won't get his turn this time.
Okay, cool. Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Okay.
Although I will actually just make a perception roll to see if it did actually notice you.
Oh, I forgot to stealth. Shit.
Okay, I think you're fine.
Okay, cool.
Roll a 10, I think, yeah.
Yeah, I forgot to sneak.
Yeah, Corvus is dead, I think. So.
Yeah, wasn't Corvus the awful goblin-y thing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, no, he's on 3 HP. 3 HP, so... yeah, let's give it the X because it was down below.
Come from a land down under.
Exactly, yes. So, Corvus will be making its attack against... the zombie. Okay, and I'll kick it.
Well, this will provoke an attack of opportunity, but I'm a run. I can run 20. Shit! 20 will give me... I need to actually run.
Yeah.
So...
Remember, you can run times 4, I believe.
Yeah, I can run 80. But I can't because there's a dwarf in the way.
Indeed.
So I'll run to this doorway. Why are there sex noises in the background of someone's feed?
That might be someone dying. It's actually the sound of death.
Ah.
Well, someone's enjoying their death a bit much.
Yep.
Well, I mean, we always have the most wonderful background noise in this show, don't we? But anyway, Delkinic, was that your full run, or...?
Yeah, well, I can't really get any further away because there's a dwarf. Dwarf, dwarf, dwarf.
Okay. So now for the zomble.
Zomble.
I don't care
Wherever
about
Wherever you're a zomble...
Oh, yes. Yes, the zombie and what's-his-face are having a go at each other in the... good luck. Good fucking luck for him to get out of that pit.
This one has, like, a plus 20 to climb.
The image that you sent us last time, he has, like, multiple arms. Maybe. Although they're kind of vestigial.
Okay. The zombie misses Corvus. Corvus misses the zombie. We go back to Dom. He's having a great time.
I am having a swell old time. Okay, now I should try and attack it twice. So, same bonus, same kind of things again. Fuck. Well, the second
the
one does 5.
Yeah.
Second one's a 5 damage at least, so.
That's a shame. Because that could have been a kill.
Uh-uh. I've become so much. How are you there?
That's 3 arrows down anyway. So make a note of that.
Yep, I've got my account. One real thing though, quick, John.
Yes.
Is stealth pretty much the same as in like D&D?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Whimsy.
Hello. I think I've still got a few more times I can punch it in the face with my brain.
Yes.
Yes, I can. I can punch it about 3 more times, I think. Ha! No, make that 5 more times. Brilliant. I'm gonna move to... can I move a small amount, do something, and then continue moving?
I'm afraid I don't believe you can.
So I can't essentially go there, punch him with my brain, and then move back?
No.
Does it actively say I have to be able to see them?
Yes. We have to have a line of effect.
Okay, if I stand there, can the dwarf get past me? Or do I have to stand there? If I stand there, can the dwarf get past me?
You can go through allies, as long as you don't stay on, end on their square, yeah.
Oh! Okay. Had I known that, I'd have run further.
Never mind, I need to be closer to punch him with my brain.
Yeah, that's too far. Yeah.
I need to be one closer.
Yeah, you do.
Okay, let me punch it with my brain. I know it's only doing 1d4, but every little helps.
Yeah, and hopefully you'll roll better than a 1 this time.
Yeah, one would hope.
Yeah, it's a 2.
That's a hit.
Well, it hits. Yeah!
Hey.
I'm getting there.
Yeah, unfortunately for you, Nina.
Come at me.
Meaning that to attack them, couldn't you? I would now have to end on the same square as Whipsy.
Yes.
Unless I do something like CMB or whatever.
Yes.
So, I've done it before. John allowed it because it was thematically appropriate.
You could try and push me out of the square and take my square, couldn't you?
So on 22, Whimsy, are you hit?
Yeah. Just a bit.
22, I'm hit. Fuck.
Just a bit.
So you take a big bite. To your shoulder. A 4 damage. As you get bitten, you feel a large amount of wrathful thoughts begin to swirl in your mind. Could you make me a will save, please?
I can try. I can make a will save.
You easily just discard them as
I'm not angry.
Bad
thoughts go away.
Excuse me.
And around over the top of the first one, around square swings down.
Yeah. Rip Whimsy. Oh,
good. Yeah, so meager damage there coming from the combined attacks of both Sinspawn. But how is Grunyar doing?
Well, tell me, John, would I be able to, in a single charging motion, go from this square to this square to push Wibsy out of the way and push these guys back.
Ooh, that sounds like you're going for a bull rush. That would be quite a difficult CMB check.
Multiple
steps or single step, John?
It would be a single step, but you would have to roll well enough to push Wibsy out of the way and then push them back.
Is that would that be going against a reflex or a CMD on me?
Okay. What I will say is because you're technically going through Wibsy Square and you won't be ending on it, that as long as you, if you roll well enough to end on the Sinspawn Square, push them back, Wibsy will either be able to not move or move one square adjacent to any way it's where she's in currently due to your charge.
Okay.
Let's let's try it. Bad, but not good.
Beats my CMD, so.
So, what would you say that does, John? Or are you about to roll their defense?
It's not a roll defense. It is. I can tell you. Not enough.
Okay.
You push the first one, but he can't go through the one behind him, so he stays where he is.
Okay, so I'm now where Wibsy was, and...
Yep, however, that beats Wibsy's CMD, so I'll let Wibsy...
Do I get...
Shift one square.
Okay. As you push me to the side.
Okay. Does that mean I get to do an attack?
No, that was your entire turn.
Okay. Well, I'm now in thing, and you guys are hopefully safe.
We'll see. But now back to John.
Sorry, I heard that. Fuck you. And it was so. So we shall see. Fuck you.
Sorry. I need a bigger muffler on this microphone head.
The mouth.
Oh,
that's not good.
It's only the Vargul. If they kill Dom, then it doesn't matter because we've never met.
That confirms the crit, right, Tom?
What, yeah. Against my AC? Yeah.
Yeah.
I've become so mad.
Does that hit you?
Yeah. Does a 25 hit me?
No. Does the 20 hit you?
Goes, fuck you and plays a space marine.
Well, I haven't got my shield out. So yeah, it would hit me.
Okay.
Well, this seems like fun.
So, on a crit, 6 damage.
Okay.
What weapon is it using?
It's using a bite.
Oh. What crit effect does a bite have?
Well, I can tell you. Well, I mean, I could tell you if I knew, but I mean...
Because that's...
There it is, found it. Okay. Could you make me a fort save, Tom?
A fort save, sure. I swear to God, if I get a fucking disease...
Could you,
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh, okay, well, never mind.
Oh!
Wait, should I roll to confirm?
No, saves don't have that, just attacks.
Yeah, I know. For fuck's sake.
This is not your day.
No.
Okay.
But it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year.
John, can I have a new character sheet, please?
Welcome to 2017, everybody.
Poison. Don't worry, you've just been poisoned.
Oh, just been poisoned, that's alright.
Are you doing solely crit effects or crit damage increases as well?
I will just be doing the regular Pathfinder crit effects.
Okay, so the crit times two, because it bites an unarmed strike, essentially, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. So you're not using the crit range damage things, are you?
No.
No. Cool. Okay, never mind then.
So, the effect of this is a mystery.
Right.
It's now Corvus's turn. I think you're really wondering what that effect is now, aren't you? You're really curious.
Well, I guess I'll find out at the beginning of my next game.
Does it make his eyes fall out?
It's just...
into an undead half orc. No, I'm not telling you. Not right now, anyways.
Oh shit.
Okay, one of these days. Oh no, that is a hit. Okay, zombie dead. Volcanic.
Well, but why did it not have the description?
Don't worry, folks, we have the highest of quality control here.
Yeah, I'm used to being able to write the macros and therefore them being able to do what I want them to do rather than using built-in ones into a character sheet, which apparently that's me rolling channeling.
I mean, to be fair, they break half the time anyway, so...
Ooh.
Yeah, but then I fixed them, the other half. So, Grignard, Wibsy, in that order, have some heals.
How much heals? Oh, 4 and 3, okay. That actually brings me over capacity.
Doesn't to me.
Over capacity, I'm just too healthy!
Quick reminder, you can't go above maximum.
That's why it's called maximum. Yep. It ain't just for funsies.
Dom, back to you. You have a Vargwill on your face.
Do I feel anything, like, in regards to bite? Or...
I'd say pain.
Love.
Oh, apart from pain, obviously. But... Right,
right now, no.
Hiya, John. Shit. In his turn, could I have taken a 5-foot step at the end of his go?
End of its go? No.
Well, I've got the ability that lets me do that.
Oh, do you?
The one that lets me use a 5-foot step as an interrupt.
Oh. Sure.
I take 5-foot step as an immediate action. Cool. So
I guess it's still... When what happens?
It just says as an immediate action.
Yeah, but when? What is the trigger?
I'll see what the trigger is. Yeah. Step up.
And if anyone says tumble, you're out of the game.
Fuck's sake. Allow me to find the feet on my PDF reader. It's a mega piece of shit. It just says I can take it as an immediate action. Oh, okay, no, slightly different. So if they make a 5-foot step, I can move along with them, essentially. Okay, cool, never mind. So what's disengaging from combat?
There's only the withdraw action, which is a full round action.
Can I do like an acrobatics or something to make it half?
Well, what is it you're wanting to do?
I just want to take a step back and shoot him.
Then you can take a... As long as you don't do any other movement, as a move action, you can take a 5-foot step.
Alright, I'll take a 5... Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, I'll take a 5-foot step, yeah. And I'll shoot him. Or attempt to shoot him.
I don't believe that provokes...
5-foot step.
Check.
Alright, cool, so... Hey, 10 damage.
So you what? You take a step back,
just
and then shoot it in the face.
Yeah.
It's a miscellaneous action. Does it provoke? Yeah, okay. So, not 10 damage, and it falls out of the air.
What else did it bite to me, out of curiosity?
On your face.
Literally on my face, okay. Yeah. And I don't feel anything yet?
No, you don't yet feel anything.
Okay. That'll be me done.
Yes, it would. Whimsy, your turn. For the record, you can attack from where you are in melee, should you want to.
I'm just thinking, is it worth the risk of then being hit back or moving backwards and then using up? I don't really have that many spells. Oh wait, I do have normal cantrips spells. Okay, I'm gonna move back. In fact, I'm gonna move to there so that it's moderately symmetrical. Don't judge me.
You are being judged.
And then I'm gonna cast Acid Splash on the one at the front.
I swear down if you hit me.
Make that ranged attack.
Oh yeah, sorry. Okay.
There's your one damage.
Yay!
Oh, that was a note. It was noticeable, so that you got that going for you.
Yay? Question mark.
You know, it's just like one damage against something, and then if you noticeably see the health bar drop, at least you've got that going for you.
True.
It's just so disheartening when it's just like, yeah, you crit it for like 30 damage, and then you double it, and then you don't even see the health bar move, and you're like, fuck.
Yeah.
Right, let's see what happened. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, let's see what happens, eh? Mm. So, I don't know where I'm typing, but it isn't in the text box. Okay, so this first one. It tries to bite you through your arm. It's probably not going to go very well. As you can see, it doesn't. Just kind of chomps on through your... What are you wearing, chain?
Yeah, I'm wearing... one second. I believe I'm wearing just chain. No, I'm wearing scale mail.
Ooh. Yeah. Trumps through your scale bell, doesn't really get anywhere. And then the ransworth from the one at the back, which kind of swings over the top.
And also, it doesn't get through my AC. Yeah.
Just kind of, smashes into your scale, bounces off.
Or my shield, whatever.
Yeah, all that. And then your turn.
Right. can I use one of my abilities? Let's have a look-see. Have I used one of my abilities this... I think I used my Stone Strike on What's-Her-Face.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, so I won't be using that. Although, is that technically an encounter, or...?
I believe abilities are once a day, normally.
Okay. Evil or of good. I guess I'm just going to beat stick it. Currently.
Now, what is your beat stick of choice in this combat?
I believe I've got. I only have the one weapon.
I have two, but one's a bucket.
I only have a dwarven war axe.
Okay, so go ahead and beat stick with your dwarven war axe.
Okay.
How are you swinging this time?
Well, I have been a dwarf. I have plenty of expertise in swinging an axe in small corridors. So this is an overhead strike because there's plenty of height for me to swing, but not necessarily width. But I'd like to push forward with the shield to kind of like a... So backhand with the shield to try and set them off balance and then bring down. So kind of sideways and upwards with the shield and downwards with the axe. And then that's going to be my attack. That's the best way to describe the attack. And then I'll probably go into defensive stance or whatever.
Yeah, well, if you roll, that'd be good, yeah.
Nice.
Okay, so what I'm thinking here,
yeah, that's shit.
Is you kind of swing with the shield, and it just kind of the shield slams into it, and then doesn't move, doesn't really get move at all. It kind of just absorbed the weight of the attack, and you just kind of knocked off balance with this, so you just your swing misses completely.
Okay. But now I go into defensive stance, I believe, which means I get I believe that's an action I can make. I believe that's an action every character can make.
Defensive stance is a full round action, I believe, isn't it? It's not on the move action list. If you're on about total defense, that's a standard action which you don't have anymore.
I don't.
Plus you attacked, obviously.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Just I know I did something in previous sessions where I'd like just do a standard attack and then I'd just like basically ready my shield.
I don't remember. My PDF reader just crashed, so give me a second.
Okay. Defensive stance is a stalwart defender thing.
I'm pretty sure it's total defense.
Total defense is a standard action.
Yeah.
Oh. I just did an attack, which is a standard action.
Yeah.
Ah, but I'm not using my movement.
Yeah.
Great. Use your move action to fuck off.
You know how to say the kindest things.
Next, it's Corvus's turn. There we go. That is a pretty good roll. Okay. Okay, so Corvus took his turn. Dalkinic, yours. That TV is really fucking loud.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because Grunyar's alright, I'm going to use my last Cure Light Wounds on
Dom.
Whipsy.
Ooh! I can live!
On the guy that's just, like, far away.
Mm. 7 points, nice.
Oh, it's touch.
Eh. Oh.
What,
never mind then.
Reach 10 feet?
Hmm?
No, what you need to do is you need to get a spell called, like, Elastic Limbs or something.
That would be cool.
Dom, your turn.
So it's a 50% recovery on arrows, right?
Ah, yes.
So evens I get them, odds I don't?
Yes.
Cool.
That's only if you miss, I believe.
So what have I hit?
You hit with all but one.
Yeah. So the ones I hit, do I just get back then?
No, they're lost.
Because if I miss, I'm still going to technically hit something, aren't I?
Even if it's the ground.
Hmm. Oh yeah, I thought it was just a 50-50, I'm just tired as I get back.
I don't actually think it says, so I would assume it would meet with what. Oh, here we go. ammunition that is hits its target is destroyed or rendered useless. Ammunition which misses, 50% chance of destroyed loss. So, evens, you get it back.
Okay, cool. So, yeah. I get that one arrow back, do you? Right, so as I kind of walk over the head thing.
Yes.
Did you say it was the face that got bit, right?
Yes.
So, as I'm walking, I'll just rub some alcohol on that wound. Maybe try and clean it out a little bit. And as I walk to this door, I'll kind of just take the arrow out the wall.
Mm-hmm.
Or wherever it is. And then I will do the same as I did before and open up the door with my arm and draw my bow back at the same time.
Okay.
Sorry, I just put my arrow back in.
So, yeah, as you go up the stairs, Dom, you are going up.
Okay, so...
Sorry, you're going down, actually.
Going down. So I'll move to
going
there.
Down, down.
And that'll be...
Trying to turn it around.
I can move twice, can't I?
Yes.
Move up the turrety. Do I hear anything, by the way, John?
Do you want to make a perception check?
Sure. And also, I will attempt to stealth as I go along as well.
Okay.
So, perception... Yeah. Do I hear anything?
You don't hear anything.
Alright. But I'll just sneak along as I'm going.
As you reach the bottom of the stairs, you see a red marble statue, a strikingly beautiful, at the same time monstrously enraged human woman in the middle of the room.
Okay. Oh, I wonder where that's from. Deja vu!
Indeed.
Alright, cool. Well, yeah, so I'll stealth about. And let's go.
Your turn.
Okie day.
I'm going to throw it back real quick.
I'm going to throw acid at him again. Yay!
Awesome, roll that D3.
Yay!
Does your acid damage, like, ever do anything other than... raw damage, like will it?
No, not with
melt
the cantrip
armor
version. No, not on the cantrip version of acid. I'll check if there are any higher tier ones, but that one doesn't.
No. The really useful thing about it, though, is that it can crit.
Can it? What does crit do to it?
Well, you just double damage.
Okay.
You're rolling 2d3.
Right. Yeah, because it says at the end this acid disappears after one round.
Yeah, it means it doesn't do ongoing damage. That's what it means.
Yeah.
Okay, so another bite comes at you, Grunya. And another ransomware. Same as before, doesn't get through your mail, and just knocks off your shield.
Awesome.
So what are you doing this time?
I'm going to do another swing-a-ding-ding. Let's see if this works. There you go.
Oh, very good. A strikingly brutal hit.
I like to imagine his the one at the front. It's one of its arms is kind of hanging slightly loosely, as I've cut a lot of the tendons on it. That's what I like to imagine.
Ooh, yeah, very good. So, Corvus is done.
Corvus and the zombie.
Dalkinic, your turn.
Is he actually there? Him? Or is that Corvus? Is that the model you're using for Corvus?
That's Corvus, yeah.
So he's actually downstairs?
Yeah.
That's good.
The door is open, I never closed it.
I can get... Fuck it, I can run up there.
It's technically that's down.
Is it?
You can tell by all these pictures, whenever you're looking at the pictures, just go with them. The lighter the stair is, the higher up it is. So this is upstairs compared to this downstairs.
Actually, I'd best be here to be in range to heal you if needed. So
telling us is a free action.
Pardon?
Well, if because it's your character's turn. You can look down there, see that it's gotten out of the hole, and tell us that it's gotten out of the hole.
Oh, it's got out of the hole.
Metagaming, we know it's out of the hole, but...
I didn't realise it was out of the hole. I just heard John say, Corvus's turn, Delkinic's turn. I didn't realise that was it actually getting out of the hole. So yeah, I'll pass that on to you as I slide in beside you. So just sort of, I'm clumped in the corner by the side, and just point up and go... It's out.
Gonna angrily say it needs another thumping.
Okay, is that your turn?
Yeah, no one needs healing, and I can't do anything but heal.
Okay. Well, I mean, actually, no, you can swing. They'll have cover, so they'll get a bonus to AC, but you can swing your hammer.
Oh, I can attack from here? Yes, despite it being around a corner?
Yeah, well, technically, you kind of have corner-to-corner contact, so they have cover, but you can still attack.
Cool. I like the way that you said you can swing instead of you can hit them, because we all know that that's a different kettle of fish.
Oh dear, how much damage do I take?
Fumble confirm, fumble confirm.
Yeah. Oh, you lucky...
That! Why couldn't I roll that? This is like first session over again. I've made two attacks, and I have fumbled them both.
Oh.
Why do I roll so many ones?
If this is like first session,
Jesus
I'm planning...
Christ, guys.
No, I'm going to lose another eye!
Prepare a special eye patch to protect his one good eye.
Your turn.
Oh, back to me. How convenient.
Oh, I need to look up rules for playing a blind character.
So...
Well, you never know what you've rolled, so, you know.
Is there any, like, footprints or indications?
No.
Okay. I'll,
Yeah.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Yeah. You see the fresh corpse of, a half-orc.
Okay. Huh. Well, something's bad's obviously gone down then, hasn't it? So that's my full movement. One of my full movements. And I assume I'm still stealth, right?
As far as you know.
Alright, so I won't do all of my movement. I should be okay a little bit. So I'm still kind of like ducking behind this little bit of what I assume is banister there?
Yeah, kind of.
So I'm kind of like ducking behind that because I'm still stealthed. I kind of see this thing's over there in the distance, and I'll draw my bow.
You can just about make out the sound from the combat now. The slashing of bone and sinew, the clashing of steel upon bone, and bone upon steel.
I'll move there, remain in cover, and draw my bow ready for next turn.
Okay. Whimsy.
I'll throw more acid at them.
Okay.
That's all I can do.
Do you have a spell still in your...
Nope.
Oh.
Nope, I used that on... Rillium was the name?
The first one, yeah.
That misses, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, I can see the purple arrow of salvation.
Or do
you're assuming he isn't just going to kill you? Does the bite get through your armor, Grunyar?
No, neither of them do.
We never know. This guy could think we're the enemy.
You might be
there. We're still the enemy.
Grunyar, your turn.
Right. Let's hope for an attack. I would like to say I swing my sword, my diamond sword, but I don't have a diamond sword. So I swing my dwarven war axe.
Hey, John, real quick, can I be scaled up? Because I'm tiny.
Are you? Sure.
Yeah, look at me compared to Ruka.
Well, to be fair, Ruka is a lot bigger than you.
To be fair, Dom's also pretty big. Yeah. But obviously not Ruka's big, but...
To be fair, Dom's tiny. About the same size as Whimsy.
It's supposed to be 6 foot. I didn't realise that.
Okay, so after a standard attack, I make a move action. I move. Oop. There.
Okay.
Is someone twisting the heads off cockroaches?
I don't know.
No, that's... I'm dealing with the sellotape right now.
Is
remember,
it from
folks,
those people?
I usually use cards, level. But...
the highest level of production standards over here.
This video might even be edited before it goes out. Probably won't be.
I'm just dealing with Christmas stuff.
Sam, Christmas was a long time ago.
Christmas
was last year, Sam.
Packing it away, Tom.
It was last year.
One year ago.
Corvus is coming down the stairs. Up the stairs.
He charges.
So I imagine I hear that. Shit.
Yeah.
God damn it, someone kick him down the stairs!
Am I in trouble?
You might be. No, you're fine, yeah.
Okay, cool.
All is good in the world.
Today is the day when everyone rolls badly.
I don't want to die.
I think I'm the only one who hasn't rolled badly.
I haven't been too bad except for my fort save.
You jinxed it.
Dal Kinnick.
I'm a charge.
Can you be a different square?
What?
You went into his square momentarily.
Only slightly. I was mostly in this square. Yeah. And what bonus does that give to hit?
It gives it plus one.
Excellent. Add one to this.
I think.
Oh, congrats.
It doesn't really matter anyway, so...
Really?
But rather than lamenting over poor rolls...
Lament over poor choices.
Poor life choices, yes. Dom.
Okay, so these things there, they're aberrations, aren't they?
Yes.
Yeah, they're Dom. Obviously not normal things.
Right, I shall attempt to shoot one twice. So I get a minus one to hit, but plus one on the damage. So, ooh. So 7 damage, and I assume the other one doesn't hit.
Well, it's kind of preoccupied with me. What do you think, John?
Oh, that's the point, yeah. I'm also
I'm actually just going to be... I'm just going to check some, so I realise it's in best theory 2 and you have best theory 1 open.
Also, John, also I'm stealth, so does that mean it goes against us flat-footed?
No, you just get a bonus.
What is that bonus, John?
Well, I'm going to say it's a plus 2.
Okay.
Because that's a go-to. I can tell you. Yeah, that's a hit.
Oh, both of them?
Yeah.
Thank. Alright, so that's 7 plus, so 12 damage.
Do you only crit on 20?
Oh shit, that's a good point. I want to say it's only 20 for my bow.
Yeah, I think bows because you're times 3, aren't you?
Yeah, crit multiplier yeah. times 3. Exactly.
Okay. So that's a plus 1 on each damage roll, yeah?
Yeah.
Because you have the aberration campaign fee, don't you?
Yeah, that's the reason why I'm getting a plus 1 to my damage.
But don't you get the plus 1 for point blank?
Yeah, but if they're within 30.
Oh,
it's
okay.
46, yeah. So 12 damage.
So yeah, you, Grunyar, you see these 2 arrows fly across the bridge and slam into the back of the Sinspawn.
Okay. Because all our turns take in very short amounts of time of each other, as it's kind of, I guess, slightly stumbling forward from having 2 arrows in its back, I'm readying a upward swing from the bottom up with the axe.
Yeah.
Ooh, be very careful about using the word readying. Ready actions never go well. Actually, in combat, they're not too bad, but never prepare for combat with ready actions. People, it's all fun and games until someone readies an action against a generic creature and the rogue stabs the ranger in the back.
It's all fun and games until someone loses an... Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah. Loses another one.
Nice.
Lindsay.
I... I'm gonna hit this thing with my hammer. I will triddle thunk it good.
This can't go badly.
Nope, never goes badly. Honest.
Oh. Well, I mean, if you'd hit, it would have been good, but...
Yeah, it would have. It would have been really nice.
Yeah, I mean, that's not a hit. Just wait.
Is it a goblinoid?
Yes.
If I have a plus one, does that help?
No.
Oh. Okay, never mind then.
Okay.
Hatred is just plus one on an attack, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, never mind.
Is the sin spawn going to resort to attacking the thing that attacked it in its back, or is it going to continue attacking me?
It's
going to
continue attacking you.
But it is motivated by wrath, not logic.
Yes. And so it goes at the one it can see.
Which is you.
Mm, fair enough. Neither of those hit.
Yeah. So it swings wildly at its claws as it's in pain.
Okay.
So you had that big swing readied.
Oh.
Oh, oh, fuck it.
Is this where I get a nat one?
Disappointingly not. It is, however, where you get a kill.
Awesome. So I can now move. Can I
describe the swing?
Sorry? Oh, describe the swing. So, I brought it up, and what I like to imagine was, due to the angling, I imagine I caught it underneath its right leg and cleaved its leg clean off.
Very interesting.
And as it, and it kind of like falls back and bleeds out. Dies from shock.
Yeah. Seems good.
I mean, nothing horrifically spectacular, but reasonably brutal.
You still have a movement action, man. So.
Can I do a CMB to try and put push him down the stairs?
No, that would be a full round action.
I don't care if I go with him.
No. That would be a full round action. You can't get enough there.
Shit. Can't charge either. Why did you have to go there?
No, you could just wait where you are. I mean, that's an option.
Three. No, because this guy's gonna fucking eat them alive if he hits them.
Bye.
Yeah, no offense, guys, but you're not designed to take a hit, so...
No. Nor are we designed to give out hits.
No.
Hitting is not something we're built with in mind.
Hopefully he'll recognise the guy who nutted him one and attack me instead of them.
Yeah.
So I move into range. And I say... I need to think of something. I'll wait until my next turn before I say what I'm going to say.
Ooh.
Ooh, spooky.
So, what he does... is...
hits the scary thing?
You're right, Wibbsy. He hits you.
I'm not scary. I'm just weird.
Well, to a goblin, they're both the same.
Oh, shit.
Also, you've been... Like, do you have any, books and stuff on you?
In my hand.
Oh.
They hate reading.
Writing, Wibbsy. Oh. However, it's not what you expect. Instead of swinging down the any of its weapons at you,
it gives me a hug.
Yes, it gives you a hug with its breath.
It
spews a arc of acid. Do you want me a reflex save?
Maybe.
Hold on, arc. That's not hitting all of us, is it?
No, it's more of a parabola.
I dodge into it.
Well, don't worry, you only take 3 damage anyway.
Cool.
Do you want to make me a fort save?
Maybe.
D20 plus your fort. Well, never mind, you're nauseated.
Yay, I am so high on this acid that you just spat at me.
Yeah. Dark Kinnick.
That's me.
So, yeah.
This can only go so badly.
What? We have the effects.
Yeah, it just it came a little late. What's the I can see a D20 with a 17 rolled. What's that doing?
It's taunting you, that's what it's doing.
This could be us, but you don't deserve it.
That must be the crit confirm roll. That rolls regardless of whether it's actually needed.
That's a shame. That's a real shame, Rick.
Yeah, because I'm about to fucking die.
Yeah. Dom, your turn.
Dom. Okay. I say,
Dom. I just got it. It's a Gears of War reference.
Okay, just so everyone at home is aware, at the start of the session, Sam was informed of a video being posted in a Discord chat for this group, which was the scene where he dies in Gears of War. Sorry for spoilers there. It's been out long enough. It's taken this long.
Well, I didn't look at the video.
It's taken this long, and you've suddenly got it now. It's the suddenness of it.
How long
Why?
Have you been recording for?
And well, I will also mention that I did say, yes, my dead wife is called Maria, before you ask.
He wasn't there, though.
We've been recording for an hour and 18 minutes, just shy of.
I've never played Gears of War.
Me neither.
It's actually discounted pretty okay on the Windows Store.
Oh, I own them all on my Xbox, so I've just never played it. It's the Gears of War Special Edition Xbox, I just never played it.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's pretty decent. Well, the first one, though, for mechanical reasons. Although he's playing co-op, so okay. Anyway, back to the game. Dom, your turn.
Alright, I'm going to do a sick combat roll. Scream something in my in my vest, because I'm so fucking manly.
You're going to say the word something as you scream it.
Alright, so what I'll do, I'll do a sick combat roll here.
Yeah.
And then I'll move up. Oh. Yeah.
Remember, you can't take a 5 foot and normal movement, so.
Yeah, I only moved at 25.
Okay.
And what I'll do is I'll shoot that goblin there. And I don't take the negative for shooting into melee, because I got that feat.
Ooh.
So, wait, is it a goblin?
Goblin, yeah.
Okay, so I'm just rolling this flat.
Yep.
Fuck. Wait, is it within 30?
No.
It's not. Okay, so I just aim a little bit too high and just...
Yeah, the arrow goes whistling down the corridor.
Hmm.
Whoopsie.
I'm going to hit it.
Well.
I'm going to swing at it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's better.
Because if I do hit, I do the most damage with my hammer. If I hit.
If.
It's coming.
It's always an if, though.
It's coming, but it never hits.
I've become so...
I even used my magical enhancement on my strength.
You see, that was your mistake. You should have gone Dex.
Yeah, but that wouldn't have made an effect on me actually hitting with a hammer.
No, it would have made it an effect hitting with all your spells, though.
Yeah, but they've pretty much all hit. Pretty much
except
all hit.
You can also increase your AC.
The thing is, it didn't increase my modifier to put it up on Dex.
Nauseated means you can't attack.
Okay, so I'll just vomit instead.
Yeah, you just stand there vomiting. I mean, you can still move.
I think I'll take a 5 foot step back then.
Yeah, that's good plan.
And spew all over where I stood earlier.
I mean, you can still vomit over Dalkinnick if you want, so.
Spew all over Dalkinnick.
I'll try.
Please kill it.
Whistled over Dalkinnick's head. Well, I say over, it's quite a bit over, but either so.
Mm. I'm going to try another CMB check to push him down the stairs.
Okay.
Because I don't like him, no siree. Actually, do you guys think I should do it with a headbutt?
Yeah.
I just want to point out that because you don't have improved bull rush, you will provoke.
It's alright, you're wearing armour.
And I've got a reasonable amount of health. Yes, so because of my thing, I get a hard-headed, I get a plus one to attack rolls and combat maneuver checks made using a helmet. I have a helmet and I'm headbutting.
Okay.
Okay, so I believe that means that I CMB at plus one. So, CMB. 13.
You do not! Now time for the attack. Okay!
I'm so numb.
Okay, not confirmed.
But I was about to say, is this how I lose my other eye?
Yes.
Who's it hitting?
Me.
Grunion, because it's the this is the provoke. This is its turn. Nine damage. Some a nasty nine damage is just slashes across Grunion's face as he swings his head forward.
Oh, you know what it is. If he had been 2 inches in a different direction, he would have gotten what my eye. But instead, he just slashed open my eye patch.
Yeah.
Now you need a new one. You're going to be wandering around the town again, taking off your helmet and going, do you know where I can get an eye patch? I lost an eye, you know.
I love how I never said that.
No, you did. You did.
I'm pretty sure I did.
The memes.
Well, you can watch back the VODs on YouTube to find the exact moment when Dalkinic first, second and third said, I lost an eye, you know.
Don't you mean when Grunion first said that? Or you find when Dalkinic said that as well?
His name, on my screen, his name tags over Grunion. I got confused, okay? The highest of production quality.
Oh, when you guys, you changed your name, post as, and then you posted it as me. In that sense, yes.
No, you said it out loud, and we can't do that as you. I can't just...
I swear I never said
I can't go on Discord, set my voice to Sam.
You did it once, not very long ago, but it was one of the more recent sessions where you're like, I will finally say it. I lost an eye, you know. Something along those lines. But you have said it yourself. Somewhere.
Oh, no, that, but I'm saying originally, I never said it.
Oh, no, yeah, you didn't say it.
No, he did.
Later.
No, he did. You can watch back the episode in which the episode after the one where he lost an eye.
Did he? Okay.
Yes, he did. That's why we're here. Oh, you mean say it? I thought you meant, yeah, he did lose an eye.
What? Okay. I was confused by the confusion. Carry on.
Yeah. I'm just trying to find what the modifiers are for two weapons.
I'd say it is different by one weapon.
Okay, so yeah, because it has loads of shit, it's just minus two and everything. Anyway, cut back.
Hey.
And I said, hey, what a wonderful time a day.
Oh, Arthur, fucking Arthur. Arthur memes. He totally looks like what an aardvark is.
Okay. Totally. So, let's see. Who are we going to attack here? Who are we going to attack? I'm thinking we attack Dalkinic, because, you know, Dalkinic's pretty weak.
Yay.
I'd like to let you know that if both of those were aimed at me, they would both miss.
Yeah, that's why I didn't go for you. You know?
Well, I'm assuming the 18 will hit.
I don't know, I mean, it's your AC, I mean...
Yeah, that would hit everything.
Okay, so the big masterwork axe slams into your face, dealing a great deal of...
Ow!
3 damage. Basically, he's armed with a longsword, a dagger, and an axe.
For those of you keeping count, that is three weapons. That is armed with three weapons. We are talking someone who has taken ambidexterity above and beyond the call of reasonable.
Yeah.
This is like dual wielding two-handed lightsabers.
Yeah. Only D6 plus one though. So yeah. Not quite sure why only D6 plus one. I mean, I would have thought a bit more, but who knows. Okay, your turn. You've been hit with an axe. A hand axe.
I don't like this, so I'm gonna try and return the favour. Yes!
You did it, champ.
How much health does he have left?
More than when he was knocked into the hole. When he got out of the hole.
Wait, what? Did you just take the health off him there?
Yeah.
I didn't see a movement, so I'm going to take a 5-foot step.
Okay. Dom!
Excellent. So, do I move up one and shoot, or do I shoot twice? That's the real question.
Twice. Well, actually, it depends. What's your range?
Oh no, it's easily within range, but if I move up by 10, I get an additional plus one.
Well, mathematically, you'd want to take 2 hours.
Yeah, exactly. Fucking, let's see how much maths just dicks me over. That much.
Fucking to be fair, a plus one wouldn't have helped you.
Yeah. Okay, so. As I just kind of think, what's the best way to describe my fuck up? We're rolling terribly, by the way, considering I have a plus six.
But anyway. Yeah, you have. Well, plus six, that is really bad.
Yeah. As I just kind of. I try and be cool. And what I try and do is I try and do 2 hours at once, and it just goes horribly wrong.
Thankfully, it can't. Because of the angle he's at, it can't go horribly wrong enough to hit any of us.
But wait, John, I'm still stealthing. It's still not enough, is it?
You see that, Rick? I mean, look at that.
That's weird, because when I move to Grignard Square, I can't see him.
Corner to corner,
but seeing as we're currently gridless.
Yeah, but you still... Yeah,
So you'd be able to hit my shield? Just about?
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Where was he? No, you're not still stealthed, Tom.
Okay.
I'm going to throw acid in its face. Oh wait, am I still nauseated?
That is a very good question. No, you're not.
Cool. I'm going to throw some acid in its face. That one. Oh yeah.
Awesome.
That's not a crit though, because it needs to be a 20.
Yeah. Also, that was a 14.
Oh yeah. Where the hell did all those extras come from?
Your dex.
Base attack bonus as well.
You have one of those?
Apparently. I don't know how, but it's in that one of those cells that I can't change, so I assume it's meant to be there.
Oh, I have a base attack bonus! I didn't think I had one. It's one.
Yeah, I have a BAB of one.
Bappy.
Yeah, we have a BAB of 1 at 2nd level. At 12th level, we get a plus 6 plus 1. I don't know what the slash means.
That means you get 2
points.
Brunia,
your turn. And I did max damage.
I swing my axe at him.
Oh yeah, by the way, the acid did no damage.
I have to hit him.
Uh-huh.
This one's all yours. This one's all yours.
Oh yes. Okay.
That's glorious.
Make a little
24 damage.
Oh, lovely.
Oh.
So, I'd like to say, as he, what was the last thing he did? He swung at someone?
Yeah, he swung and did some damage on Dalkinic.
Okay, so as he's overextended like that, I kick him in the side, and then I just punch him in right in the face with the shield arm. And then just before I bring the hatchet down to just chop his fucking head off, I say, "You should have stayed in the hole!"
Okay, I also just want to say Dwarven War Axe is a times 3 multiplier, Sam.
What? Oh, shit.
What do you mean times 3 multiplier?
That
you roll another
he would have got an extra d10.
Ooh. Do you want to just roll that d10?
There's a d10 plus 2 by lots of things.
5.
7. So you're looking at 31 damage.
Why not?
So just to put that into perspective.
Nice.
The will save.
Jesus Christ.
I just realised I've been rolling as myself the entire time.
Highest of production.
I turn around and I go, Ruka!
I'll say, at which point I'm going to be retrieving the arrows, well, attempt to retrieve the arrows, without putting the back of that dude.
I imagine, whatchamacallit, Hound, did one of you guys see Ruka die?
I didn't.
I we think I did.
You did, yeah, definitely you did.
Yeah, but did you tell us?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, you could probably have inferred it from the swearing I did.
Yeah, there was a lot of that.
In that case, I'm going to say, my dwarf is not the smartest person at times, and I like to imagine he's kind of an optimist. So he runs up here, sees a brand new human.
I said, John, how high up is this bridge that we're on?
Like 5 foot.
Okay, I see this dwarf running, so I'll just hop down.
What, so that you're on eye level with him?
See the dwarf running, move along, Sam.
And I'll try and be sneaky. Okay, I'm sneaky.
I'm just trying to find the scene.
For reference, I'll be kind of like under the bridge.
Yes.
And that's what I'm imagining I'm doing anyway.
You could have just described that, to be fair.
God damn it, it's not as fun. I imagine I kind of run over, and as I see the dead body, I kind of go like, no, no!
A reminder to everyone at home that Dom is underneath the bridge and not inside of Grunyar.
That's what you think. Hey, I have a light blade.
Hey, who's to say that I'm not inside him?
You are small enough.
I don't think my anal circumference is large enough for a
burly dwarf.
Okay.
Moving swiftly on.
I say a few words to Toreg and I say, I know she didn't believe in you, but I hope her spirit finds you in the stone.
In the stone?
Stone! With that, I close her eyes, I guess, and make her less kind of sprawled out and horrific looking, I imagine. I also take this time to
steal all of her personal belongings.
No, to neaten her up, so, you know. So you're holding your axe. No, you shouldn't be holding your axe is the thing. You should be like holding it kind of, you know, on your chest and stuff like that.
There you go, put some blood in.
Thanks, John. That's
like I always say, highest of production quality.
why don't you perhaps move Ruka on top of the blood?
Good point.
Just saying. I don't know, she covered in like a tarp of blood.
One second, I'm gonna
sniff.
It's a teardrop.
Yeah.
And then notice I only did one.
Single tear.
Teardrop's on the other eye, damn it.
Hey guys, can...
And also, it has to be on the other eye because you don't have that eye.
Yes.
Guys, can all of us just put an F in chat to pay respects?
I'm sorry, the meme that came out of that game is so good. Hey, press F to the fuck off!
Combo breaker.
As I turn around, I say, I say, do you know how she wanted to be buried? Or how she wanted to be, interred? Buried?
Return her to the elements?
I've known her as long as you have.
She didn't really have any religious ways that I knew of.
Can the goose of Ruka just appear?
maybe we should bury her in the graveyard.
I should sanctify the body.
Yeah.
Stop anyone being able to use her. Speaking of which, how do I actually go about that? Because I assume I can, what with being a cleric and all, but also I don't have a power for it.
And without much of words, I reach for the ring that gave +1 AC, and I put it on. I kind of look at it. Right, no, because I will now always have a reminder of Ruth. It's sentimental. But it also gives me +1 AC.
I think we should get Ruka home or to Sandpoint. Or at least somewhere where if for some strange reason someone suddenly stumbles across this place. Can I perception to look around to see if I spot Dom?
Hey, I did roll a 27 on my stealth.
Oh, so. You can roll perception if you want.
Because I'm pretty sure I saw him when he was first at... Nah. So,
no!
Because there was that human with a bow just here. I don't really want them stealing Ruka's stuff, but we can't carry her around with us.
So as Dom, as Wispy kind of looks around, I kind of see, after she turns away, she kind of hop back up on the bridge. I lean up against the wall, get out an apple and just start biting into it. I'm being really casual, pretending I've been there for ages. And as I got half a mouthful, I would kind of swallow and say, "She worshipped the element. She probably just wanted to get buried." I just kind of take another bite into my apple.
I didn't hear a word of that.
So
that's how good this stealth was.
Oh. Anyway, I'll say she kind of clear my throat and say, "Sorry. If she worshipped the elements, she'll probably just want to get buried." That's what a lot of half orcs believe, anyway.
I turn to him and I say, "Well, if you help us bring her back out, I guess there's no harm in giving you her share for this venture."
Before we go, can I check that goblinoid thing's corpse for things?
Familiar with half orc culture?
Met a few on my day.
I'm going to walk into this room, sort of squeeze past Dom.
Hey, I'm leaning up against the wall.
Okay, well, I'll just sort of toddle past you.
Okay, you search the corpse, and you find a medium size +1 longsword.
Ooh.
A silver dagger, and a masterwork hand axe.
Ooh.
Again, medium sized?
Yeah, they're all medium sized.
So I can use the dagger as a sword?
No. You can use it as an inappropriately sized dagger.
Oh, so it's not like Sting?
No.
Oh.
I'll just kind of say, whatever's fighting her very clearly had a bad day. Then again, shall we see by the looks of things?
Is that all that was on the corpse? No, like, gold or...
Nope.
Okay, well... I'll hand them over to Grunyar. Do you want them? I don't know this other guy.
I can carry them for now. What's your name there, human?
You can call me Dom. In fact, that's what my name is. So just call me Dom.
Hey Dom, you want a magic sword?
Sure. Dom just kind of looks at you, shrugs, just like, yeah, sure, why not?
Hold it, I mean.
We say we're missing a compatriot.
I was kind of pointing towards Ruka. And just kind of just nods, just like, yeah.
Would you, at least for the meantime, be in the market for what's the local adventuring?
Well, I'll kind of just finish off the final bite of my apple and just kind of throw it to the side. Finish my mouth and just say, well, I was just walking through town, then the floor collapsed, so I ended up about 100, 200 feet away from here. So I have no idea where I am or where I'm going.
You said the floor collapsed into these catacombs.
Yes. So we could have a mutual kind of agreement here, because I didn't want to end up here, and I ended up here. So.
Okay. Well, we must protect the people of Sandpoint. Everything that's within these catacombs, because of that opening, we're going to have to kill everything. I think we've already killed most things, to be perfectly honest. There's lots of old magic here. There is a fountain. I recommend you do not drink from it or step inside it at all.
See, now you're tempting me to do exactly that.
May I give you a good reason not to? And I'll just gesture down to Ruka.
Does the fountain cut you up?
No, it sends you crazy. Scary when she's crazy.
That's the small well. As for the fountain, I have a good idea that I point towards the misshapen goblin, and I say, I think that used to be a goblin until it drank from the fountain.
Just kind of look back.
See the horrifically deformed goblin.
I'll say, well, three arms is pretty cool, but being deformed isn't that great. So yeah, that's pretty bad.
I'd like to see you try and have three arms without being deformed.
I'll just kind of point and just nod and go, touche. You got me there.
Hey, what if you were meant to have four and you lost one?
Well, if you're meant to have four, you're starting off at a disadvantage when it comes to not being deformed.
Touche.
So, what are you guys doing down here? Just clearing it out from the sounds of things.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Yeah, I'm trying to hunt the Sandpoint Devil myself. But as you can see, I've been inconvenienced with being down here.
That was one of our targets. Maybe. Later. A bit.
Well, that's another mutual interest. It's almost like we're fated to be. Almost.
Fate's a strange, weird thing. Much like normality.
Right, shall we get moving then? Everyone just kind of looks around.
Yeah, was there anything else? I continue this way and I say, I'll take point. I've got the shield, I guess.
Was there anything else in that room of trapdoors?
I say, there was a zombie at the bottom of one of the trapdoors.
I think we can thank our malformed friend for that not being the case anymore. They sounded to stop making any noise not long before he pulled himself out of the hole.
He only dropped into one of the holes.
Checked this room just...
Oh,
right,
yeah.
Here.
Oh, so the holes not all lead into the same place?
No.
Oh.
Should we check this room? Down here? Because I don't want things to run up from behind us.
Does anyone have climbing rope? Zombies might have something valuable on them. I doubt it, but
Oh, we can always take a look, can't we?
There's a door. There's a door.
There's a door back here, apparently.
I'll stand behind Wisby. So I draw my bow.
I say, okay, count to three. One, two, three, and I try to open the door.
How do we see? Try to open the door, you're like grabbing the handle.
Well, like I'm grabbing the handle and pulling, because there might be a trap door or something.
Oh, okay. Alderaan.
I pull, push. You know, like if there's a handle, I kind of pull it, and then if it's not working, I push, and if that's not working, then
okay,
I get ready to batter it down.
Odds or evens? Odds or evens?
Give me odds.
Okay, you pull it, and it's pushed on.
Okay. Okay. Then so you push it, and then I push it. And it opens?
Yep.
Okay. Can I?
Indeed. You open the door to find three more doors.
Oh.
And there seems to be, like, stones or something on the floor. What's that?
You find the crumbling remnants of several chairs and a long table on the floor of this room. To the south stand three stone doors, each bearing a strange symbol that resembles a seven-pointed star.
Ooh.
Huh.
I step to one side and I say, Dalkinic, you have some knowledge about religion and things... beyond, I say, I only have knowledge of the Torag and his followers. Hmm. Other religions, I know very little of.
I'll take a look at this.
You know nothing.
Well, I don't think it's religious.
Hmm. Can I give it a crack, John?
I haven't even looked in yet. There are too many big people in the way.
There is one big person in the way.
You can see
that's still too many.
Through their legs.
But there's also a Dalkinic who I can't see through his legs because he's the same height as me.
Go on, what it is, John. If it's anything
okay,
relevant.
What are you asking about? what are you...
The same thing that Dalkinic just looked at.
Ignore the perception note because I don't know how to tailor the notes to be just... to the relevant skills. I don't think you can.
Isn't it the column to the right?
No, that's the macro.
The drop down menu.
Drop down menu?
In the skills.
There's a drop down menu?
Yeah. John, I'd like to use Detect Evil on the doors.
Okay.
Wait, Sam, you haven't used Detect Evil on me yet. The fuck's wrong with you?
I know!
Big assumption. And we're all just assuming you're not evil because Grunyar should probably have run Detect Evil on you already.
Yeah.
And I'm assuming he's not evil because if he is evil, we're gonna fuck him up.
Yeah, but that's what your Detect Evil is for.
I'll Detect Evil on him when he's not suspicious.
It's literally you looking at people. Come on.
Fine. I detect evil on Dom.
Turns out I'm chaotic evil. Shit. No, I might.
Okay. And I detect evil on the sigils.
They're sigils. They are not intrinsically evil.
Back down.
So, who got above a 20 on knowledge religion?
Ah, oh, I got a 19.
Not the cleric!
I guess I'll roll, I guess.
To be fair,
I did get a 9 on a fumble.
Hey!
I don't know religion.
It's pretty good.
Religion.
I'm the only one with knowledge religion trained.
Yeah, I don't know it.
Honestly, guys, you should be taking things of a religious bent. You should be taking the person with religion trained word for that. And he's saying no gods.
I believe I am a god.
I don't believe in gods, but I know a lot about this god.
Well, there are experts in Greek mythology. They don't believe in them.
Hey, I worship the Norse mythology.
I believe I am God.
Thor. Right.
I mean, Grunyar's making for a passable Odin.
Which eye did you lose, though?
Well, no, the thing is, though, that implies that Sam's character's quite smart. And in reality... Hey, Odin said there'll be no ice giants. Do you see ice giants nowadays?
Nope.
No. Odin must therefore exist.
Right. I'm just going to say... You don't know.
Okay. So, I take a deep breath and I try to open the door.
What's behind door number one?
If door number one isn't a goat...
Oh, I'll draw my arrow. Draw my bow.
Oh, is the writing discernible?
No.
Okay, I'm going to choose the door in front of me. If he opens that, and it's a goat, then I'm going to change to looking at the door in the middle and go through that instead.
Okay.
Are we doing like Schrodinger's? Goat?
No, this is the
Monty Hall problem.
Monty Hall problem, yeah. Okay, so behind door number one is
love.
A skeleton.
That we cannot see.
I wouldn't be surprised if it's deformed or something, considering.
Oh, actually, Rick, why are you looking? Why are you looking at the pages? Can you make me a perception check?
Sure. Why not? What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, shit!
Weren't
sorry, I'm so surprised that you actually rolled well.
Yeah, I got a positive number and everything.
Yeah, while you're knelt down looking at them, you see a scroll under a nearby broken chair.
Oh, yeah.
I like scrolls. I should start writing them.
Hey, would you like to start reading them?
The Elder Scrolls foretold this moment. We're already here.
Found a scroll. On it is written weird writings.
Cool. Weird writings. I'll remember that. Weird writings. That phrase might come in useful.
I say, is it like a language you don't understand, John, or is it just really like scribbles and shit like that?
Well, it looks like part of something.
Okay.
You know that maybe a wizard would know where it is.
I'll pass it over to Wibsy.
Okay.
Why don't you pass it over to Stein?
Stein doesn't exist. Stein is the dead god.
Stein's a god or something.
So,
I mean, honestly,
god of being dead.
If you had like detect magic, it'd be good. But
didn't you say it was like just a roll of spellcraft to determine if it's magical?
Oh yeah, it'd be decent.
Spellcraft. Hey, you said DC 10.
That's a 20.
Oh right. Well,
no, plus two.
Thanks, Matthew. Fuck's sake.
Plus two.
No, that's perception.
Oh, right.
In dim light.
Oh, yeah! That's four good rolls in a row.
Oh, so,
no, five!
That's a good point, actually.
So five good rolls in a row.
And then put it back.
We didn't have a light source.
I have a lantern-y thing that I've got in my hand.
I have the light of truth.
Ooh!
A common lamp. And I've got five pints of oil. Not 5 pounds. I can't words.
5 pints of oil.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You're not technically clothed while wearing them. You are flammable.
Very.
Cool. You find a You have found a scroll of flaming sphere.
Don't use that while you're in pants of oil.
Yeah. Flaming sphere, did you say it was?
Yes. It is a cast level 5 spell.
Ooh, that can go for quite a penny.
Or quite a flaming sphere.
Yeah, that too, but I'm just saying that...
Now just imagine how useful that would have been if you found it before fighting Illyrium.
Yeah, probably. Wait, is that normal flaming sphere or greater?
Normal.
But I thought we already
as normal as a flaming sphere
resisted
is.
Resisted it.
No, it just missed.
3d6 damage.
Oh, shit.
Moves as long as you actively direct it.
It's like that.
And its duration is one round per level.
Yeah, what level is it?
It's normally level 2, but at a level 5, then that
figured
lasts for a bit longer.
Alright, so in the first door, what did we find in the first?
You found a skeleton!
Is that a dead skeleton or an animated one?
You found a badly deformed humanoid skeleton.
Yay, I'm not gonna...
In what way is it deformed?
It has 3 arms.
Okay.
Is it small?
No.
I'm trying to get through the door.
I want to
search the room proper. See if there's... Oh god, it's tiny.
It's big enough for me.
Take your time searching it. Well, there's no goat in that.
So yeah, I searched through the cell. Other than is there anything on the skeleton or
dust?
Just dust. So that was probably what was left of his clothes
and skin.
Yeah.
And hair. And lunch.
And lunch. And toilet.
Tasty. What's in the middle one? Did we even open that one yet?
No, you haven't. You've only opened one so far.
Oh, the other two will be goats.
Well, you're letting me open them because I have a shield and I have a chunk of health, so if a fireball comes out of the thing, I at least have a reasonable chance of surviving it. At least better than you guys.
What about if an ethereal arrow comes out?
I mean, as long as it isn't a cone of flame, you're good, really.
Yeah. I think I'm going to take a step back. No, I'm not.
I'm going to take a step forward.
I open the second one.
Okay.
Oops.
There you go. Okay. And inside, you find...
A goat!
No. A deformed humanoid.
How many arms? Alive?
This one. No, it's a skeleton.
Oh, it's a skeleton.
This one has an enormous, misshapen skull.
God, what's the next one?
I don't know. Is Dalkirik opening it, or is he stepping out of the way to allow Grunyard?
I'm getting out of the way.
Okay. Okay, bets on how this one's going to be misshapen.
Centroid.
Large pelvis.
A really large pelvis. What do you say?
I say centroid.
You say centroid, and what do you say, Wibson?
Hunched spine.
Hunched spine. I reckon it's something to do with its legs, or its ribs. Like spiky ribs or something.
What was the first one again?
Too many arms.
Okay, you ready?
Actually, you know it'd be really fucked up if it had like a long torso, like a really long rib cage. That would look really fucked up.
Open the door.
Anyway, yeah, I open it up.
There's a thing in there.
You placed a thing.
Yeah. Hey. It's a
what
goat.
Is it?
Goat.
Is it legit?
No, it's not legit, no. But after it going on about goats, I could not do that.
Killed me.
That's what I always try to do. The third one has a rib cage that goes all the way down to its pelvis.
And the I just inspire you to do that?
No. Oh, I'm just reading out the book.
Shit!
I'm glad we didn't put money on that.
Ribcage goes all the way down to its pelvis. And the pelvis has stunted legs that thrown up between a strangely flat girth.
Ooh, girth. Mm.
Mm. Right. Okay, so these poor deranged souls. Okay, so nothing of value then.
No. I mean, unless you want bones. I mean, yeah.
I'll give you a bone. Oh.
We could take the bones back with us to try and, I guess, ease their passing. I'm not certain of the customs of this area and how they deal with people who were deformed, whether by considering this place, I think it's by magic. Maybe the priest will know. I think for now we should leave them here.
I kind of want to examine them, but I think I understand why they're so deformed.
I think they're deformed for the same reason that goblin thing was deformed.
Nah, they're very clearly just lacking calcium. And as Dom just continues walking.
Okay.
Yeah.
I say, Dom, your bow will be of much use down here. If the pits are anything like the one pit, because I believe this was the pit that's got like all the things are broken on it. At best, we can just kill the zombies. At worst, let's just kill the zombies.
Hey.
At best, they might actually have something valuable on them, but one of us will have to go into each pit to get the valuable things.
Hey, everyone, have 1d6 more health, unless you're a zombie, in which case have 1d6 less health.
Oh, you can't do both. Shit.
Pardon?
You can't do both.
Yeah, I can.
One or the other.
It's just channel positive, isn't it?
Yeah, it's channeling.
You can only do one or the other.
It's how much health, sorry?
4. I just assumed that healing hurt undead.
No, you only heal or hurt.
Well, I needed that anyway.
Okay.
Well, if I get thrown in one of them, I could easily hurt it with lay on hands, but because I technically have that. Anyway, I pull aside this rickety wooden thing. Mm. So it's like there.
Mm. World 20 is frozen. There we go.
Okay, so I pull this one aside, John. Yes. Is there a zombie inside?
Indeed there is.
Okay, so to speed things up, how many arrows do you have, Dom?
Real quick, I'm just going to take a look, see if it's got anything noticeable on him. Oh, John.
What are you looking for?
If he's got any, like, valuables or anything down there.
No, the zombies don't have any valuables, but they are just zombies that are animated by dark magics.
Alright, I'll look down.
We should kill them anyway, because there's that opening into the town. I don't know how the zombies would get out of these pits, but if they did...
It's worth it.
I just kind of just nod and just draw my bow. I shoot that bastard.
Save your arrows, let me just dissolve them.
Yeah, sure. Then I'll just...
Okay, so I go around each of these things. I just pull these things aside. I don't assume they're that heavy, John. Are they that?
No.
So I just pull them aside so that, just everyone be careful where you're going when you've done the things.
Is it safe enough to go that over time, because they're not attacking back, I can just basically kill them?
Yeah, so we wait a short while, you kill all the zombies.
Yep.
Awesome.
Woo!
Oh shit! That was a good decision.
That's you got 700 XP. It wasn't all for the zombies.
It was for the other stuff as well.
Wait, 700? Did you say, John?
Yes.
Nice. How much one in total then?
That Vargol was actually quite a bit of fucking XP.
Pack the pain away.
What?
Hey, how much are we on total? Since I don't know.
I'm trying to find where it's stored on this sheet. Cause
I think
getting...
it's core. It's core right at the bottom, I think.
Kind of glad that combat happened off screen as far as the VOD was concerned, because that token was a bit shit.
We're at 3,990 out of
4,000.
3,590.
I've got.
3,590. Okay. Dank.
Wait, was it 3,5 or 3,7? No, 3,790.
You can literally just go to the chat log and it uploads. Doesn't matter.
Well, I had 3,090 before getting that 700.
Yeah, that's alright. I was also adding that in. I'm just going to sneak about.
So, the stairs just there that you've reached.
Mm. Oh.
They go down.
Good.
However, the route is blocked by rubble.
Okay.
It will take a long time to clear.
Let's not do that yet.
Who are you speaking to? You can't see me.
I think what John means is like it's the kind of thing you'd hire a team of
zombies,
excavation dwarves to work at for a couple months.
Yeah, somewhat like that. Okay, so you going in, Gloria?
Yes, we go in here.
Okay, so let me read to you what you see. You see a strange room, 15 foot diameter sphere. Several objects float in the room, spinning lazily in space. A ragged book here, a scroll there, a bottle of wine, a dead raven.
Okay.
Being eaten away by maggots and other things. And a twisted iron rod with a forked tip. Perhaps the thing which unnerves you the most about the room is the walls, plated in sheets of strange red metal. The ripple every once in a while of silent black electricity that seems to coalesce into strange runes or even words, far too often for it to be chance.
Hmm.
I want to study this.
Oh, so you three have all entered the room. So you begin to float.
I want to study this. Have I got a rope? I think I've got a rope.
Right, I move back in. I try to manoeuvre myself back out into the corridor.
Oh yeah, you just walk out.
Okay.
Hey.
I don't have a rope.
What are the walls made out of, John?
A strange red metal.
Okay.
Which, you said black electricity?
With yes. Black electricity, yes.
I say, what is it to move in like floatiness? Is it dex?
No, it's just moving.
Oh.
Runya, hold on to me. I want to have a look at these.
Well, does anyone have a rope or anything?
No, it's a 15-foot sphere.
So it really isn't that bad.
No.
I just don't want to float too high.
What, 15 foot? It's fine.
And even then, remember, you aren't uncontrolled. You can see Delkinic and Dom managing fairly well.
Okay.
I'm just riding my bucket like a magic carpet.
Oh, that was a terrible Arcana. Considering I have a plus 7.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
Would knowledge history help here?
No.
No, okay. Because I'm aware that there's a... some people do know about the Rune Masters, don't they?
Yeah, you'd need a knowledge Thessalonian or something.
Oh, okay.
Where it would say... I'm pretty sure it says in one of the adventure sections.
Okay, I'm going in and I'm going to have a look at these runes.
What do the words look like?
You're not sure. Just odd.
Wait, have we seen the kinds of words before?
No. The words have to... Actually, you can't read the words. You need to... they're in, over to their language you don't know.
Is it a language that none of us know?
I don't know. What languages... does anyone know... Well, I don't think actually anyone, know, anyone does know, so I don't think anyone took it, so...
I have Abyssal in common.
No.
Where are my languages? Where are my languages?
For, the language section, maybe?
Wait, what was the,
Fee?
No, there was, like, an ancient,
Racial traits?
Just for reference, guys,
Wasn't this place built by someone, like an ancient empire or something?
Possibly. I have Common, Gnome, Silver, Draconic, Dwarven, and Giant.
Like, it's also the name of, God, what? The goblin camp we were told about is supposed to be on a head or something of a giant statue?
Oh.
Of this empire or something?
Possibly, I can't remember.
I remember somebody said something about a name.
Language-wise, I took Common, Gnome, Sylvan, Orc, Dwarven, and Giant.
Yeah, I'm Draconic, Dwarven, and Giant on that. None of them are right, are they?
So I made the right choice of doing Abyssal, because no one knows that.
Okay, well, if I don't understand what the words say, then I'm going to float up and sit in the middle of the air and take out my pen, quill, and ink and start copying down some of the runes I find.
Okay.
For reference, guys, I'm about 2 foot off the ground, so I'm just lying back, just chilling. Probably trying to get some shut-eye.
I'll fill an entire parchment sheet, or so, would you say? Okay. So I'll change that to 3 and parchment of unknown runes.
Okay, so I'm just lying down, just floating in the air. It's great.
Okay. After I've, is it okay if you guys might need to step back when I do this, because I just want to test something.
I step a long way back at those words.
I'm just going to float slightly closer to the ground. Probably go back as square as well.
Over my time copying the runes and words and everything, do I notice any kind of pattern in the black electricity going around? No. Okay. I'm just going to touch the hilt of my hammer to the wall. And leave it there with my hand touching it for a while?
Nothing happens.
Okay. And you said there were floating spheres in the room?
No, the room is a sphere in which we were floating.
Was there anything else floating in the room?
Yes, as I said, several objects float lazily in the room. A book, a scroll, a bottle of wine, a dead raven surrounded by floating maggots, and a twisted iron rod.
Wait, there's a bottle of wine?
Yeah.
Okay,
I'm just going to slowly float over to the wine and just take it and just keep floating.
And I'm going to grab the scroll, the book, and the twisted metal rod.
Scroll, book, okay, so we're going to start with the first item. Dom, you take a look at the wine.
Yeah.
You see the year of brewing, or whatever it is, and wine, you know?
The vintage.
Yeah, vintage. It's
John,
a while ago.
The one who drinks wine.
It's a while ago, but I don't look at what it says, I just drink it. You see that it's quite a while ago, but not that long ago.
So a long time ago, but not that much of a long time ago.
It's a long time for wine vintage, not that long for how old this place is.
Oh, okay, so like, what, 100 to 200 years old?
No. Like, it's not that good, okay?
Oh, okay.
Like, what, like, we're talking like, yeah.
60?
50, 60
yeah.
years.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fancy. Cool, I'll look after that.
Yeah, it's got a little tag on it.
Alright.
It says, to Aurelian.
Well, she won't be enjoying it, so...
Wait, I mean, do we recognise the handwriting?
Yeah. Well, no.
Okay.
You have nothing that you would, no samples to look at that you would recognise. Yeah. So. Actually, yes, you do! Of course you do! How could I forget? You recognise it from the diary!
Yep.
What, Suto's?
Yes.
Okay, so Suto was clearly in cahoots.
Dalkinny, what was that spellcraft for?
To identify the spell that's on this room. But it's way too low, so...
Yes, it is. So, next item. We have the scroll.
Scroll. Is it... am I able to detect what it is by spellcraft?
I don't know. I mean, you'd have to roll it for that.
No, probably not with that.
Oh, no.
I'm doing good with my rolls. Okay, so I'll just put that in my pack for now.
If you had detect magic, it'd be a lot easier, but you know.
I'll prepare it when we're not in combat, kind of thing, but I typically haven't had a direct risk. Because I do have it, I just don't have it prepared.
Yeah, remember, you have more than one cantrip prepared, so.
Wait, is it a cantrip? Oh, yes, it is a cantrip! I do have it prepared! Ah, I thought it was a level 1. Okay, I'll cast detect magic on it then. Okay, that's quite a long...
Yeah, that's a lot of text.
I'm out of text.
Sorry.
Oh dear. That's...
I'll study it for as long as I need.
Okay. Mm-hmm. While that's happening, I'm going to try and map out the rest of the thing, see if we missed anywhere, in case there's any nasties lurking. Oh, we've been here! I think we've already explored the entirety of the dungeon.
Well, I mean, not particularly. Okay, so
where did he go?
Off.
Which way did you go?
Well, I'm staying here while I study.
Essentially, there's that staircase down.
I want more old 20s under freeze again.
Okay, so yeah, do you want me to make a spellcraft check?
Again.
Actually, you already did, so it doesn't even matter. Actually, no, because you've done spellcraft now, I'll let you have another one.
Okay.
Ooh. Wait, I think, John, is this the area that Tom came through?
No.
Yeah.
That's better.
Wait, is it?
You identify it as a scroll of Burning Hands.
Burning Hands. Everyone needs more burning hands.
I just like to remind you that you can use a scroll in order to learn a spell and put it into your spellbook.
But you'd still need to prepare and everything if it were in there.
But you'd then have it for future use.
Putting it in the spellbook uses up the scroll as well, doesn't it?
I think so. Well, of course.
Can you tear a page out of the spellbook and use it as a scroll?
No.
Oh. No. Yeah. You can write scrolls, though.
I'd actually find it quite worthwhile to be able to pull a page out of the spell book and use it as a scroll, because it's like, yes, it means you can use a spell you've not prepared, but you can't prepare that spell anymore. So it does come out kind of balanced to do so.
Maybe. I would never do it.
The thing is, it's because in the scroll, the magic is imbued in it, which takes basically like casting the spell. Whereas in the spellbook, you're not doing that. You're basically writing down how to prepare it.
Hmm.
So it's not the same thing on the page.
So it's like a recipe for the reagents needed and what word you're saying, etc.
Yeah, whereas a scroll, all the magic's already bound in there. That's why you can cast it immediately.
Yeah. Okay, so that was the scroll.
Yes.
I'll put that in my pack. The book...
The book. Okay.
Do I want to roll detect magic? Do I want to cast detect magic on that as well?
I don't know. I mean, that is your character. Do you want?
I will cast detect magic on that just to check that it's not magically trapped.
Okay. Well, you detect an aura.
Okay. I'm unable to determine from detect magic what the aura is. Can I?
If you make a knowledge arcana check, you can.
We'll give that a shot then. I probably can't tell.
You cannot. You just know it has a magical aura.
Okay. I'll ask
Dom.
Do
you want to open it up?
I'll ask Dom to move further back a bit. Just in case.
Moral 20. Okay. Moral 20 is officially unfrozen.
Excellent.
Cool.
And I accidentally logged into D&D instead of Pathfinder. Bear with me.
Okay. Well, let's just say I've told you to step back. I'm assuming you will want to step back when I'm examining things that could potentially explode.
Sounds great.
Also known as, while Loops is around, things.
Yes! So, back off and I'll open this book. I will gingerly open the first page.
It says... words is what it says, because you can't actually read it. Back of the front of the front cover, you can make out one word.
Mm-hmm.
Irelium.
Okay, I'm keeping this book.
Okay, I think I'm pretty satisfied that I've explored the entirety of.
I'm gonna put the book in my bag, but make sure that it doesn't touch Irelium's corpse. Just in case.
Okay.
There's also a twisted metal rod.
Yes, or wand.
Wand. Detect magic?
Sure. And then do you want to make me a spellcraft check?
Spellcraft check. Damn. No.
No, you don't know what it is.
I'll touch the wall with it.
Cool. You put the wand against the wall.
Mm-hmm. Leave it for a bit while holding onto it like I did with the hammer.
Look a bit silly.
Okay, cool. I'll put it in my bag.
Yeah. Suppose it is a little daft. I mean, after all, it's a wand and wall.
Yeah.
I was just checking to see whether the wall wanted to electrocute me. It clearly doesn't. So
well,
it must think I'm a friend.
Maybe.
Or maybe it's not actually possible for it to electrocute anyone.
You never know, it's got weird black electricity on it.
Yeah, but that's
sounding racist.
So maybe it doesn't act like normal electricity.
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna touch the wall with my bare hand. Does it feel like normal metal?
Yeah.
Okay. Does any of the black electricity sort of accumulate around my hand?
No.
Nothing happens at all?
No.
Okay.
What if we take some of the metal? Maybe that'll make us float.
No.
Does this seem like somewhere that would make an appropriate bedroom for someone who just floated? And didn't need much space?
Well, not a bedroom.
An office.
A study?
Study.
Yeah, maybe a study.
What I'm going to do, I'm going to spin... kind of stand up, do a flip whilst I'm still floating, and just land perfectly back in the normal zone.
Okay.
Just because you want to.
Just because.
I make my way up the stairs back into the town. I plan on bringing this, what has transpired, to the attention of the mayor. The mayor's still there, I believe?
Yeah.
Okay, cursory glance at the dead raven. There's nothing, raven or crow, whatever it was. There's nothing special about it. It's just dead bird.
Could all of you make me a perception check while you're near the stairs?
Skills, mate.
Oh, I changed to Dom, but yeah, 20.
Gun. I'm nowhere near, so.
No, but you were earlier.
Okay.
Okay. Brynjar, Dom.
Hmm.
At various points while you're passing the stairs near the floaty study, I think you can hear howling coming from far below.
Howling as in like wind howling, or like howling as in bork?
You think maybe strange dogs or something, but you're not quite sure.
So bork howling, okay.
Maybe we can get some help with people, with some workers to try and excavate further down.
Like I said before, you know it'll take quite a while.
No, that's what I'm saying. So we commission the workers to excavate while we're off doing, like, basically while we're using Sandpoint as a point of operations. And well, hell, maybe if we just tell the mayor about it, he'll send someone to.
She.
Sorry. I've forgotten what all the people in the town were like.
They like people, Sam.
Oh,
it's been
people.
So long.
I've been.
Wait for me.
Never.
Never.
So, Bruno, what are you actually doing there?
I'm making my way back up. I'm literally making my way downtown.
No, you're not.
Going for that.
I thought that this is the way that Tom came up, so...
It's blocked.
But if he came down...
Hey, then... Sam, why don't you look up through the ceiling?
Oh.
Yeah.
Came through a hole, right?
Yes.
Do we have any rope?
Rubs hands. Well, funny you say that.
Didn't know you're into that.
Oh
shit, is this where you mage hand some rope around something at the top and then we climb up?
Yeah, I mage hand something? How? How on earth am I going to do that?
Well, if you have some rope,
you
then
have
I...
the rope, then...
No. Yeah. For the record, there was no hole, those stairs are completely clogged up.
Alright, so how did I fall down then?
Because you fell through a hole, which, as you fell, other things fell, sealing the hole up above you.
Ah, okay.
Oh, right.
Well, then it can't be a very deep hole. Do we have any digging implements?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I have a picked hammer.
You could do that, or you could just, you know, walk back.
Yeah, we're not that far. I mean, wasn't it just... Ooh, hello. Wasn't it just down here somewhere? Yeah, where Dalkinnik is.
Yeah.
In which case, so we got the stuff off Corvus.
We got the stuff off of
really all the loose. All we need to do really is carry Ruka back.
Yeah. I'm imagining me and Dalkinnik not being much help in that. Although we can take some of her equipment just so that she's lighter to carry.
I thought you were going to say we can take some of her weight with Mage Hand.
5 pounds. So... What loot... Not loot. Equipment did Ruka have?
It was a lot, but I shall tell you once we go into my inventory.
What do you mean Ruka's inventory?
But Ruka's inventory. Fuck off. So... I had, let me just whip out a calculator real quick. Or my penis, either or. Both of them could do maths fairly well, so.
Yeah, better than you anyway.
Why does everyone think I'm bad at maths? 91.5 pounds of just gear on her.
How much pounds of gear was that, sorry?
Let's use a close calculator. 91.5.
I can only carry 40 of that.
And Ruka herself weighs quite a bit.
Yeah, I can't carry any of her.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to be leaving a lot of Ruka stuff behind.
Leave all the food, but bring useful materials.
I would personally... I mean, this may just be personal preference, but I would consider food a useful material.
Okay, fine. You don't need to eat. Okay, stuff like flint and steel and grappling hook, maybe not, because I think between us we've got enough grappling hooks, maybe?
Yeah.
I've got one.
Okay, so she's got 50 feet of silk rope.
We'll need that. Hook,
a shovel.
Folks,
a portable ram.
Just see, take two trips.
Yeah, that'll work.
I honestly think we can do all of it in one go, though.
I'm not sure. Having been doing carrying capacity calculations for the last couple of days.
Let's just flash forward then.
Yeah.
We flash forward, having carried Ruka and her belongings out.
Dibs on the gold.
Well,
No, we should have like a party pot, per se.
Yeah, party pot. East.
Yeah.
I'll put down the stuff you would loot from a Ruka.
Stir that on the loot list, but I took the ring.
Of course you did, you fucking Jew.
Hey man, I am a dwarf. Oh, and then you've also got the is it the plus? It's the plus one AC. Yeah, because we're not doing like third edition D&D, or was it third edition or second? No, I think it was third edition where paladins had to like put a percentage of their money, all their belongings and money and stuff away. Which is, yeah, I'm glad that that's not in Pathfinder. I just have to be, you know, a stand-up person.
Mm.
Yeah.
Is anyone managing the group loot handout? Or shall I?
If you want to do it?
Yeah, sure. Okay. Did anyone claim anything from above? I know someone's got that Ransur. Oh, wait. Ruka took it, didn't she? Okay. I'll start from the bottom.
I'm not sure that she took it would be the word that would be. I mean, she did take a ransom to the face.
Yes, but the masterwork ransom that she pulled off the statue.
She could have done with putting that in someone else's face first.
Yeah.
Why did that when I had an axe?
Anyway, Doc, would you like to perform the eulogy for Ruka? You got a gallon of ale?
Yeah.
What? I drink it all in memory.
Gallon of ale?
Yeah, you can just buy a gallon of ale. just in a little barrel.
No wonder you were so fucking heavy.
I wasn't actually. I was actually within my own, within the light category.
What?
Yeah.
I'm over my light.
I know you're a barbarian, but that's still kind of crazy.
I'm into medium. Actually, with my my magical strength enhancement, I am still into medium. Never mind. I'm just weak.
Yeah, I could carry quite a bit.
You're weak.
I'm small. I'm small and cute. Don't judge me.
You're judged. Okay.
As I think over our time with Ruka, I remember watching her nearly torture a monk to death. I remember running in fear from her and trying to hold up a door while she tried to murder us all. And I settled for saying, from the elements she came, and to the elements we return her body. And consider that the less I say, the better, considering what I knew of her.
Dom will pour a little bit, you know, pouring out for the homies.
Rest in peace, Ruka. You nearly killed us all.
I'm just thinking about it. The, considering that Ruka had a personal ram, I'm kind of glad that she was enraged.
Was that her goat? The...
What? Oh, I see what you did there. Yeah, I was kind of glad that Ruka was smashing the door with the axe rather than with the ram, because she'd have caught up with us if she'd been using the ram.
Yeah, just like, the door takes one hit and we go, we ain't mending this anymore, run.
Well, since she was in, like, super age, you know, I don't think she would have had the cognitive function.
Yeah, that gladdens me slightly.
Yeah.
There is a small crowd that has gathered to pay respects. People are very sad.
Of course they are. I was the best. Christ.
Ruka, who ran from one goblin to another, just one-shotting them.
Don't wish can't go. She sounded like she was a bit of a hoot. And just pull one out.
You already pulled one out. Pouring the whole thing.
No, man. For my homies.
Wait, who's got the thief tools and the flute? Does anyone have them written down?
I don't think anyone took them.
Okay. I might take up how to play the flute then, just to annoy everyone. Because you know you'd love it.
What's your charisma?
Low. I know, 14. High enough. Okay, now I just have to find the actual costs for it.
What skill does perform go off? What skill, sorry, stat?
I assume charisma?
Yeah, charisma.
Okay.
Considering the time, is that a good place to end it and...
Sure, we can edit down the VOD for later.
Yeah.
I'll go to the tavern, try and get some wenches.
I will just sit here putting money and stuff onto the group loot, so how much everything costs.
So, what are you all doing next time? What are your plans for tomorrow? Because it's getting a bit late.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and we've reached the dead end with that investigation.
Well, not quite.
We have books that we can't read. We need to try and find someone.
I need to spend some time studying these thoroughly and see if I can find anyone who understands these runes.
Yes, again, just wenches a beer.
I mean, who are you asking? First of all, I mean, you haven't shown the book to anyone yet, so.
Yeah. What's the centre of magical learning in Sandpoint? I know I've asked this before, but I keep forgetting.
I would say magical learning is probably the wizardly dude who runs the shop down in the south of town.
Oh, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to try and open up the, I'm going to try and find the area. With the mayor's blessing, I'm going to try and find the area that, that Dom fell through.
There's already a cleanup crew going at it. It's, maybe not the right words there. That came out a bit wrong. it's up here.
So they're actually...
They're resurfacing the road.
Oh, so they're covering it up?
Yeah, because it kind of fell through, and like a load of dirt kind of. So there's a few, like, there's probably a square meter or so where it's just kind of collapsed.
Oh, they need to. They need to not do that because there's something else down there, and you don't want it suddenly popping up through your road.
So you're telling them they shouldn't resurface the road and should leave the hole there?
No, I'm saying they should put, like, barricades around the hole. You know, they need to somehow and... I don't know whether they plan on getting the catacombs as part of the town.
Sam, if they were
They're just covering it up. They're not going down there.
If creatures were going to come up, they could just come out of the glassworks.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Or out of the hole you're asking them not to cover up.
I was thinking more along the lines of, like, you could
send someone down.
When you said covering up, I was thinking along the lines of when some, like, if you have a pothole, you basically just pour tarmac in.
Yeah, they're just resurfacing the road.
Yeah, but how much is that gonna take for us? Because if we need to go down there again,
you can just go through the glassworks again.
The same way that we just went down. We're not gonna punch the hole in that Dom just fell through just to take a shortcut.
Hey, John, can I sue the council and get an insurance claim?
You'd have to hire a lawyer for that.
Cool. And they don't come cheap.
No.
It's like 50 platinum pieces for an hour.
It's pretty expensive. And then they take a pretty big cut on the trial as well, so... Oof.
Cool.
Now, what you need to do is you need to find a lawyer. You need me to have a look at all your lawyers, and then you need me to check to see whether they're evil or not.
They're all evil. They're lawyers.
Yeah.
They are the definition of lawful evil.
That's altruistic. That's too young to be. That's young and altruistic. Or maybe old and fed up and altruistic. You never know. Now, yeah. I think that's it for tonight, really.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see how much of this actually makes it onto YouTube.
Yeah.
Probably about 45% or so.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were going to say 45 minutes and thought, sounds a bit optimistic, that.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Well, you could cut out all the ums and ahs and stupid jokes and...
So we're cutting out everything you say then, sir.
Yeah. Shall I just not upload this?
So, last time we did this, but we're not posting that video because it's shit.
If we like actually start streaming again, like three episodes, like Dom knows the party really well, all of us are good friends, everyone's like, who the fuck is this guy? Where's Ruka gone?
Where's Ruka?
Well, I won't be around next week.
Our following.
Well, most of us are in here.
Wait, so most of the people who watch our things are ourselves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're not a big group.
We have good quality control. You have to question how you're still on the show, Sam, to be honest. But
we need more clickbait titles. That's what we need.
This is what happens when things die.
Ruka does what with her axe? Episode 1.
Episode 1 of 0.
Shit. Yeah.
Episode 1.
I mean, we lost episode 0, so...
Episode 2. I only have only one eye. It's more likely than you think.
Episode anyway. 2, not the amount of eyes Grunya has.
Episode 2. Little dwarf gets skull fucked by goblin.
Anyway, I won't be around next week. But the week after that should be back to streaming again, as proper internet will be being fitted in a week and a half. I will probably still be able to play, and if Nina's streamable,
maybe. It's mainly because my cough is hideous and running a stream by myself is.
You're still dying.
Yes, I now have the flu as well as a chest infection. It's going brilliantly.
Just drink some bleach and kill off the flu. And
I know, I might as well. I've been tempted to take up heavy drinking just to kill off all the death in me, but that, no, it's not going to work, apparently. It's a distraction.
Bye.
Bye.
See ya.
Sorry, that was my hour. I might have woken my family up.